After four, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hopefully, you can begin to see that playing a chromatic scale this way creates a shape across the fingerboard. And in order to play it well, just think of where you need to place your finger that plays the first note in each 4-fret group. If the first finger's in the right place to begin with, then it's easy for your remaining fingers to continue and play the other notes in the sequence. I really encourage you to develop this exercise for yourself. For example, give this a go. Every time you've completed playing the scale shape across all the strings, either up or down, try starting a new chromatic scale shape, but a fret higher. See, I'm playing down in pitch here, but instead of going back up through the same series of frets, I'm going to shift up a fret like this before I play the scale shape back up. Then, once I'm at the highest note again, just like this, I'll move up another fret before I repeat the chromatic scale shape down across the fingerboard. I guarantee that this exercise will really help you gain greater control over all of the fundamental techniques that need to come together when you play the bass. If you find that you're still thinking about what each of your hands are doing as you're playing, then this exercise is absolutely perfect for you. And with practice, you'll soon be able to focus solely on the playing rather than thinking about how to play. Just keep practicing, and I'll see you next time.